Imagine a world where you're plunged thousands of years into the future. You have to discover new tech, fight through aliens and cyborgs, and find the mothership that now controls the Earth and destroy her. This is 100 Days in Hardcore Minecraft in the future, inspired by coffee-fueled genius. Let's get into it. My first vlog where I'm going to give away $10,000 to people who can compete in Squid Games and win is coming out soon. The link to the vlog channel is in the description. Enjoy the video. The world was at peace, nations united under one flag for the betterment of humanity. We reached for the stars in hopes of new technologies, but we reached too far.
Spaceship to command, we are seeing an anomaly on our radar. We will keep you updated. Command, come in! Massive ships are coming from the black hole! Come!
This is command, can you repeat? Can you repeat? Earth was invaded. Humanity had one last chance, but time was running out. As I spawned into the world, I found myself on a ship in midair. I quickly began to run as aliens began charging directly at me. I ran to some glass panels I noticed that were broken and jumped out for my life. I then pulled my parachute and I was hit by an alien that jumped out right after me. What is going on? As I began to glide, I saw a giant city overrun by aliens. Drifted to its borders and began to run. This was going to be a crazy adventure.
Whoa, what is that thing? What? What is that poor sheep? That poor, I'm not going over there. No. Just gonna leave that be.
I found a tree and began to knock it down, but in the distance I saw some wrecked buildings. What is happening here? I thought to myself. I made some tools and began killing sheep. I then noticed some weird barrier. I tried to investigate it and all of a sudden a dirt block attacked me. Future tech is weird. I dug down into the earth to grab some stone and then I made a furnace and smelted down my food. After wandering around, I realized I should mine till morning. I then found some iron and some coal and then out of nowhere,
I just need a bit more iron and then, ooh, what is that? What is that? No. I'm gonna die. What is this thing? Oh, there's more. I am not going that way.
These caves were not to be trifled with. I was not returning anytime soon. I would need advanced gear before pushing deeper and deeper into the depths, maybe even some robots. When I returned to the surface, I made some armor. It was futuristic iron armor. With a newfound confidence, though, I began exploring the destroyed city.
Alright, so there might be some supplies left behind before the city was evacuated. I just have to find where they would be. It seems like a lot of these buildings are connected with bridges or something like... Oh, a chest. That should take everything just for now. Actually, I'm gonna take gunpowder too. We might need that for something. These black holes, they just sketch me out. Like, what is... Wait, is it... Oh! I thought I was gonna do more than that. Okay, they're not that bad then. I wonder if they grow bigger, though. That's the only thing I'm worried about. What the heck is that? That does not look like the normal city. Oh, that's in... The black holes are getting bigger, I swear.
This futuristic building was in the middle of an old rundown city and didn't make sense why it was here. I walked into the room and I saw a chest at the end of the hall.
That's so cool. Ooh, a chest. What do we got in here? Ooh. Alien chest armor. Android torso? Oh, this is for upgrading yourself into a robot, literally. That is so cool. Okay, let's get rid of some of this crap. Why is that man on fire? Oh, he's at me! No. Is he dead? What killed him? Wait. Did he drop? Oh, he dropped it. Laser blaster. Pew, pew. Oh! Wait. We gotta try this. Alright, what the heck is that? Is that a microchipped creeper? It really doesn't seem to care. I'm gonna try shooting it. Oh, this has so much. Oh, he's got so much health. Ooh, what'd he drop? A circuit. This mod pack's getting crazy.
The sun was setting, and it was time for me to find a safe place. I noticed some stone in a cavern, and I dived down to investigate. I found a giant rail system under the earth, and I began to follow it. The tunnels seemed to go on forever. I could only imagine the other dangers they held.
What on earth are those? They look like the other dudes, but they're huge. Oh, no, 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 no. What is that sword they have? They're starting to guard the underground. They're going to be everywhere soon. I need a base or else I'm not going to make this. All right, well, this is slightly sketchy.
I found this track that seemed to be floating in the middle of nowhere. I tried walking on it and I fell right to the bottom. It was a PogChamp move nonetheless though. I began mining to finish off my armor set. I had to begin the construction of my base soon using Tectopia and then begin my transition into half man, half robot. But to do that, I'd need a lot of resources. The power that I could wield could topple the alien invasion. As I dove deeper in the mines, I found some cyber shards, and then I noticed some diamonds out of the corner of my eye.
Oh, let's go. Come on, B3, give me 3. Yes, we can make a pickaxe with that. What is that? Whoa. Oh, it poisons you. Oh, don't step in that. Oh, shoot, I'm gonna die. No. Please. That can't be how it ends. No. That was way too close. Oh, holy. That dude just spawned right in front of me. Absolutely not. He can't fit. Let's go. What are these things? They're spawning more and more as we get more to this world. We need to get to a... Frick, we need to get out of here. We need to make a base as soon as we can.
After leaving the mines, I found some sheep and I shot them with my new blaster. It makes cooked mutton. How convenient. Everyone needs one of these. While exploring, I came across a strange village.
Something about this doesn't seem normal. Where are the villagers? Oh, there's one. Let's go. What kind of trades they have? Wait, what? What on earth? Chests? Is there anything in them? Ooh! What is happening in this world?
I was making my way through a dense forest when I came across another one of the beams. They seemed to be some sort of wall, but I couldn't figure out what they were keeping out. I found the top of a sunken building and decided to make my home in it. After shutting the doors, I set up a bed and furnaces, and I made myself the rest of the tech iron armor. I then sprinted outside in the middle of the night to grab some wood as I needed it to make torches to plunge deeper into my house and see what was underneath the top floor.
Alright, oh, this wood looks awesome. Okay, I need to be very careful going down here. We need to light this up so that we can sleep upstairs. There's definitely, yep, there they are. Okay, they're just normal zombies. Oh, there's a lot of them, though. I created some space here. Nice. Is there a spawner or something we need to take care of? Oh, hello. Don't light me on fire. All right. Oh, this goes right into it. Oh, okay. This is an adventure for another time. Another time. I'm going to get back up. Oh, yes, it let me sleep. I have no idea why, but let's go.
The first thing I did when I woke up was learn how to make hardened walls. During the game, the mobs will become increasingly alien-like and will begin to attack my base as I grow bigger and bigger. These walls will be a primitive defense against them, but are better than cobblestone walls. I gathered some gravel and sand and returned home. I then made walls and began placing a perimeter outside of my base. I made some iron doors as the finale and I placed them as my gate to stop intruders from entering. With some basic defenses done, it was now time to begin on robots. Sending humans out there was growing far too dangerous, and to gather resources, this was my safest bet. I began the creation of a mining turtle. When you add coal to them, it enables you to program them to do certain tasks.
Alrighty, and there's the turtle. Wow, that doesn't look like a turtle at all. Now the question is, how do we give it... Ooh, okay. No, I think I know what to do. Unfortunately, I do think it needs a diamond pickaxe, but... I don't think it can break. So do I, I put it into inventory? It should be holding it. Oh, I figured it out. I'm a genius. Okay. So now if I place a turtle go brr. Okay, I'm gonna grab this. What? Maybe I don't wanna go that way. I do not wanna mess with that guy right now. Let's go over here. Hmm. Oh, there's another one. They're spawning more and more. Thankfully, they're not too close to my base, though. I think I can avoid them. I guess, let's do it behind the base. Yeah, let's do it down here. Okay. So, if I place a chest down, and then I place this bad boy down. So, if I type in excavate 5x5 and I hit enter, no such program. Okay. Let's try that again. Let's try 5. No such program.
After tinkering for a few moments, I figured out the command and I sent the little robot to begin digging. This was epic. But now it was the glooming task. It was time to begin creating a civilization. This was not gonna be easy. If I was gonna fight back against the aliens, I'd need humans and robots together to unite. I could start work on my own civilization by building some structures, and then I can hire villagers to come work for me. I just won't tell them the part where they're going to war a little bit later. I found an alien that made its way near my base, and I used my blaster and I took it down. I tinkered with some factory blocks, but I really didn't like them. I needed to make a town hall to begin inviting citizens to join me. I then realized I could mine out the building below me and use the white stone for the town hall. It was now time to begin building the town hall. I went for a futuristic theme as I wanted to make the entire empire like this. However, there was a darkness dwelling in the land, and I was going to need to try and contend with it while my empire was being built. Miles from the base, I had seen a giant enemy camp. A ship had landed and imprisoned villagers that I would need to start my town. Before generating a plan to save them, I began by making a town hall marker. This would begin my settlement.
Alright, so if we're gonna make this town hall, first I wanna put a floor in, so when the villagers arrive, it looks a little bit better for them.
I placed an item frame above the town hall and then a door, and then it was complete. The town hall started lighting up, and it was time to start my colony. But now it was time to save the villagers to grow my empire, and I had a crazy idea. Below the campsite, I had noticed that there was a railway system that ran directly through it. If I could find a way to funnel the villagers out, I could use the rails to escape. They would have no idea. I began by making some minecarts from the iron that my turtle had mined.
Alright, I'm pretty sure the bottom of this tower, there's a train station that connects to it or runs under it. If we can get ooh, is that a chest? If we can get access to it? Ooh, this is actually gonna come in clutch. What is that? I'm gonna take that for now. If we can get access to the tunnel system that runs across here, this is gonna be super good. This is... Here we go. All right, so what we do is we mine up all these tracks and then we make a station that goes that way quickly, right to our base. And then once the tracks are led to our base, we can sneak into the camp and get the villagers out and then just we transport them back, easy peasy. And then we start our own nation. Now, the stronger we become, the aliens are gonna come and find us and attack us, but if we can get our defenses up quick, we have a chance. All right, I think if we mine up right here, we can get back to the surface. Then you put the tracks down, then we go and try and save those villagers.
After I dug the tunnel down to the main tracks, I made a small path back to my base and then began placing tracks all the way up to connect it to the main track beneath the earth. I was now ready to journey to the enemy camp. On the way there, I only lost a cart a few times.
Oh, oh, and there we go. No, 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 oh. All right, Will. Oh, yes, stop. Okay, let's break this up. Thank you. All right, how do we figure this out? All right, maybe if we start, let's try starting this with powered rails. Put that there. Let's put this over here, and let's give this a try. Here we go. All right, this should push you all the way up. Yes. All right, perfect. This will get all the villagers here. Now we just have to worry about getting them out of that prison.
On the way there, I noticed some of the tracks went the wrong way, so I corrected the path to connect it to the main line.
Okay, so the prison is about right here. Let's see. We look on the map. Oh, actually, we need to come back a little bit. All right, right here. So, if we try and mine straight up, we might be able to drop them through. Okay, let's be smart about this, though. Let's put some water right here. And then we don't want them to escape, so that'll be perfect. Okay. And we just need to mine up there and see what's going on. All right, so I think we're under the base. I can definitely see them. That looks like the prison. But it looks like we have some water in the way, so let's block this off. Break that through. So is that gonna fall into water? No, this one will. Okay, let's break this through so the villagers don't die. That'd be kind of a failed mission. Okay, let's get all the way up here. Question is, am I gonna... Yes! Here they are. Here they are. Okay. We need to get them in this hole. And if the aliens notice me, it's not gonna be great. Okay. Shoot. I have an idea. Alright, we should be able to sneak them down here. If we can make them fall into this water pit, I think it'll push them to the middle. Or at least get us closer. But if those aliens notice us, we're so screwed. Okay, they haven't noticed us yet. Okay, let's keep going. Let's get greedy. I'm gonna get this last one, then we gotta go. Come on, you're standing on a corner of a block, man. Really? I don't know what your name is, but you're an interesting fellow. Okay, if we can push them through, come on. Please, I'm trying to save your life. Go, villager. This is ridiculous. Okay, let's get rid of the water. Oh, shoot. Okay, that was a loud noise. They know I'm doing something. I need to get these guys out now. Okay, let's push. Come on. Come on. Please. One down. Come on. Just right there. Just there we go. Okay, let's one down. Let's get another one. Come on. All right, looks like Beth. What is wrong with your... Oh, it's got a parasite. I gotta kill it. I have no choice. Shoot. Okay, well, we're down to two. And then there were two. Okay, I need to get you in the pit. Oh, this is not good. Come on, Beth. I don't know what your name is, but I'm naming you Beth. All right, Gerald, you're the last one. Please, get in the hole. Quick. Okay, please. Oh, shoot, they're coming. We gotta go. Okay. Oh, we're all stuck in the hole together. No, this is a horrible idea. Okay. This is an issue. All right, we didn't set up the tracks all the way here. Okay, let's quickly get these down. Go. We need a powered rail, like right here. Okay, they're coming. This is not good. Okay, let's get a minecart here. Hope if these guys can't be pushed, we're in trouble. They have to be able to go into a minecart. Okay, there we go. No, you're going the wrong way, Beth. Beth, the other way. Beth, you had one option. Oh my gosh, no. Go the... Okay, this is ridiculous. Go this way, Beth. There we go. There we go, Beth. Okay. All right, Gerald, you're next. Come on, big man. Get in the cart. There we go. Okay. I don't know who you are, but get out here. Oh, no. Shoot. Okay, we can save him. We can save him quick. Okay, if we can do this quickly. This is not good. Okay, let's get all these down. Quick. Go. Okay, let's get a cart. Get in the cart. Okay, I think that's everybody. We gotta get out. Oh, no. Run. No, go away. This is the most anticlimactic chase. Go. No, that's coming. Where are you going? Oh my goodness. Oh my god. Guys, what is going on here? Did we just run over Beth? Is Beth dead? Oh no. I'm so sorry, Beth.
When we got home, I broke them out of their minecarts and set them free. This was the first part done. Now it was time to design the housing for them and begin my own transformation into becoming a stronger, futuristic being. I then noticed some sort of cyborg on the mountainside and I used my blaster to take it out. They were growing more aggressive and this camp was getting big and I needed to gain power quickly before they came after me. I grabbed some supplies from my turtles mining and went back to camp. I found two cyborgs though by the town hall and I took them out. I really needed to start defenses and I needed them fast. I began by clearing out an area to design my house for the first of the colony when all of a sudden...
Someone get killed back here? What is going on? Oh, there's a villager over here. Oh, there's a lot. What is happening? Who's attacking them? I'm so confused. Yeah, I have no idea what was attacking them, but I think whatever it was, they took care of it. The traveling merchant. Okay, I need to get the first house up so we can keep villagers.
I then built the frame of the futuristic house, and once finished, I grabbed some beds to make it a home. I placed the item frame above the door, but it didn't seem to work.
Ah, who needs doors anyway, right? Okay, if I put this one on here, it should register it as a house. Maybe. What if we do this? Nope. I'm gonna have to lower this one down. Come on, there we go. Okay. So, we should get villagers now that this becomes their home, I think.
As night fell, my village was invaded by civilians. I quickly went up and grabbed a farmer token and I right-clicked on the passing civilian and turned them into a farmer for my own village. As morning broke, I went to grab some resources from the turtle's chest, and I found a robot sitting on top of my chest. I yeeted him into the abyss and reset up my mining turtles. Once I programmed it, I headed back to the base after collecting the resources from the chests. After returning to base, I made a coal generator. I needed to start getting into tech and start advancing myself if I wanted to become powerful inside of this mod pack. After making the generator, I smelted down some more ores and began making the parts required to make the pulverizer. However, I ran out of food. With nearly no health left, I found some wildlife nearby. I noticed a building on my way back that had been leveled by some sort of attack, but I was very torn to investigate it, so I decided just to leave. I did not have enough health.
Alright, we've run out of sprint, but I think we're gonna make it back home. Nothing's around, we should be good. That was so stupid to try that. Was there something there? I felt like a block was there before. Okay, let's get inside. We need to put our food into smelt, like, right now. And actually, let's sleep. Alright, come on. Just need to smelt this. I'm watching the windows, because some of these guys just break right through. This is going to get way too dangerous.
My food smelted, and I was able to heal up. Thankfully, I survived, but the challenges were still ahead. I then headed outside to gather some supplies for my next machine, when all of a sudden...
Once we have the... What is that?
Run! No! Oh! It's a robot thing! No!
I don't know what to do. Run! I am so screwed! Get out! I need to make it up this hill. I have never been so freaked out before. What was that thing? I don't even want to know. All right, we need to get back to base.
I arrived back at base and found some robots inside. I took them out and headed into my fortified base to smelt down some more food and finish the resources required to make the pulverizer. I placed it next to the coal generator and it began to power up. A pulverizer would allow me to double the ores I place inside. This would help me a lot with advancing my tech. I crafted some cobblestone walls. The robots and cyborgs can break these blocks, but it will work against some of the more primitive alien forms and it'll slow down the other aliens.
Alright, oh, whoa, why is he in here? How did he get in here? No, get out. This is not good. Get in the house. This is ridiculous. They're trying to get into my other villagers. They might have already killed them. You guys sleeping? Oh my gosh. I don't have a choice. Like, I literally, I have to stand here all night. This man is standing on, okay, well.
As morning broke, I headed outside, but the cyborgs had left. I found the breach in the wall and repaired it by grabbing some excess wall. It was now time to begin collecting the resources for my next big structure. I headed into the basement and began collecting the concrete when all of a sudden...
Whoa, what is that? No!
This is... No. Okay, can I open up a piece here? Maybe. Oh, no. Okay, play it safe. Okay, let's break a block here. We got him once. Okay, there we go. It looks like he doesn't want to shoot us through the embers. All right, come around the corner. There you go. Let's go. Another hit. He can't have too much health. Actually, no idea, but presumably he won't have too much. Oh, he tried to shoot at me. And there we go. Let's go, boys. What do you draw? Laser creepers, plasma units. Huh. Alright, well, let's collect this and get back to the surface.
I cleared out some more walls and rubble around my base to make the area a bit bigger. I wanted to build more structures and potentially guard posts as well. I then crafted some torches and I placed them everywhere inside of the base. I then began working on the next structure. This would be the storage room for all the villagers. When the right door marker is applied, villagers will use this as a warehouse to get supplies from, store things, craft, or smelt whatever tools they need to perform their tasks. This will be the central hub for the economy. However, this was only a distraction. The next big task I had to complete was making a modular power suit. The modular power suit is an incredibly strong armor set that's expensive to make but will keep me protected from the enemies to come. I knew I would face an onslaught of aliens at some point and I had to be ready. I finished up the floor with some flat concrete. My chat was all of a sudden spammed though, with one of my villagers taking damage, so I sprinted out to see if I could find them. I slowly made my way outside and as I got to one of the corners, I looked below me and the alien
man was right there. The villager was unfortunately dead, and there was no way I wanted to face that thing, so I slowly backed away. I finished the front of the storage room using pillar blocks, and then I added my doors. I grabbed an item frame, put it above the door, and then placed the storage marker inside of the item frame to then signify where the villagers had to come.
Alright, we're almost out of food. If I place the crafting table down, place a chest down, and then place some wood in it. I'm gonna make a hoe, just in case. Alright, so if I place the hoe inside with some wood, the villagers should start coming to the storage area. And oh, here we go. Here we go. Yes. Okay, she's coming in. I don't know what she's doing. She's grabbing stuff. She grabbed the seeds. Did she grab the hoe? Oh, there she goes. There she goes. There she goes. What's she gonna do? This is so exciting. I'm so excited. Alright, so this is gonna be pretty primitive, but I looked it up, and apparently, if you till the land, the farmer should recognize it, according to the wiki. Oh, she's doing something. She's doing something to the land. I don't know what she's doing. Oh, we need to get her seeds. We need to get her seeds. Quick. Here's a seed. Will she plant it? Here. Throw it to you. Oh, another one's coming. Come on, plant the seeds. Come on. Please. Okay, everyone's lining up. I don't know where they're going. Can somebody plant the seed? Oh, I think I figured it out. So if you place the crop, then they'll plant it. Okay, so if I place potatoes over here, I gave some of them potatoes. They should come over here and then plant the potatoes. Easy peasy. Okay, here she comes. Here she comes. Come on, please plant the potato. Please plant the potato. Okay, I don't know what she's doing. Come on. Plant the potato. Why is this so exciting? No, stop running into her. No! Come back, please. No, Betty! Ah, you suck. Bald man.
I then went back to the farm and they had planted all the potatoes. Bro, all of a sudden I was being shot at by lasers. I began trying to juke the cyborg, but he lit me on fire. I circled around trying to put it out.
I forgot how much. How did he get in? I'm taking so much damage. Get out. This is all my food. Literally, this is all my food left until this stuff grows. This sucks. This sucks so much.
I climbed on top of the house and used the epic PogChamp angles to kill him.
This could be the end, boys. I mean, I could stay up here, but that's not what PogChamp would do. Can I hit you? I can! Okay, but he can hit me every time I hit him.
When he died, he dropped his laser blaster.
Did I get his blaster? Full energy. Let's freaking... How did he get in? How do they keep breaking the fences? That's ridiculous. All right, now we just need to... What the heck is going on over there?
I went to the wall of my base as I saw some fighting and there was massive aliens and cyborgs fighting.
What is happening? Nope, you are not coming here. No, thank you.
I began unloading on the alien as he was trying to attack my villager.
It's hitting my dude. Oh. If I unload my fall, I have to unload it all. I have no choice. It's still alive. It is still freaking alive. Can I sleep? Can I please sleep? Okay, I can sleep.
I ran back to my house and I slept the night as it would be safer to fight the aliens in the morning.
They're gone. Why did they leave?
There were resources everywhere and they dropped a crazy amount of XP, so I collected it all. Thanks for the donations, boys.
Okay, let's throw all that out. Let's just gather what we have going on around here. This is crazy.
Now that my turtle had brought me the resources, it was time to begin the construction of the modular power suit. I grabbed the resources from the chests by the turtles and headed back to base.
Alright, first things first, let's pulverize the iron. And then what will happen is it will double the iron output and give us 2 iron dust. And those iron dust can then be smelted into iron ingots. And there we go. 2 pulverized iron. So if we come up here and then we put the pulverized iron in there, we give it a few seconds. Boom, baby. 2 iron ingots. This is going to make it so efficient. And then we can get started. We need to build a power armorer table. To do that though, we're gonna need electrum ingots, and electrum is a combination of silver and gold. So we're gonna need to pulverize both silver and gold to combine it so we can actually make the tinker table. I'm also curious, are they holding bread? Whoa. I'm also curious to see how many resources they've collected so far. This honestly isn't bad. Why are they 2 different kinds of wheat? If I combine them in here, if
Can I make this into like one bread? There we go. That's pretty sick. Like, these guys are gonna get crazy efficient. And the best part is, once they've made a lot of crops, I can start trading with that wandering villager that comes through to get even more villagers, and then we can start a guard post, and like, this is gonna be sick. But let's get back to the power armor.
I continued grinding down more ores and smelting them to prep the table required to make the power suit.
Whoa, what is that? What is that? No. What the heck? What is it doing? Is that a drone? No. This is so hard to hit. This thing is so hard to hit. Stop it. Who needs an alarm clock when you have a flying attack drone coming right at you? This civilization is becoming too big. Like, we need to armor up. We need to armor up now. All right, it's time to make the power table. So if we make this first, get ourselves a tin gear, and then we make the frame of the actual machine, and then all we need is this. Grab that, and here we go. The power armor table. This is going to unlock some powerful things. All right, so we need to go get some silver, and I feel like our best bet is if we just dive down into these mines, honestly, and see if there's any left on the side that the turtle missed.
After jumping into the mines, I looked around and headed into the mines when I found an abandoned dungeon, and I found two chests inside, so I looted the items.
I really don't want to know what that noise is. Nope. I need to not fall down there. Okay, there's gotta be some silver around here somewhere.
I jumped down into a large area as a PogChamp would and began wandering around looking for the silver that I needed. I found some on the floor and then began to head out.
Alright, should I find the right way back up? Then it should be... What on... Oh, my ears! My ears! What is that thing? No! Stop existing! Whoa. What? What? To you? Oh, no. I am going the opposite direction.
When I got back to base, I continued prepping materials and then I crafted the tech chest plate. I went into the tinker table and began looking at the enhancements I could put on it. I grabbed all the computer chips that I had and began looking through to see if I could install anything onto the chest plate. I had a high voltage battery that I had found in a dungeon and I added it to the chest plate to store power. I then made some leggings and began browsing the enhancements I could put on them. This armor was going to be so strong when I maxed it out. I made some more components so I could add a kinetic motor to my leggings. This would enable me to generate power by simply walking around and provide a lot of protection. I didn't have enough resources for a full set, so I made iron tech boots and a helmet to supplement the rest of my armor. When I ran outside to test it, I noticed a new villager. I then realized the child had grown up and we had made a new citizen. However, I noticed some robots on the corner of my town and I tried to attack them, but they repelled me back, so I just left them outside as they didn't seem to be breaking through the wall.
All right, I think this space would work good for the extra barracks. If we put, or if we put another house here, or perhaps a... Okay? That's not normal.
I was shot by a creeper riding a dinosaur shooting lasers. What is going on?
I'm just gonna try hitting it and see what happens. Come here.
I went in for the assault, but they did a lot of damage, so I hid behind the home like a PogChamp and healed up.
Okay, if we... I'm just trying to think. He doesn't do too much damage with his power suit on. We might be able to get him. Can we ride his T-Rex?
I charged back in and I killed the creeper, and then I tried to ride the dinosaur. However, he wanted to snack on me instead, so I ended up fighting him and I brought him down.
I don't know if he cares. Oh, he cares. Let's just back up in here. All right, I think we can challenge him now. I think we have enough health. Okay, can we get out the door? Let's just fight him from here. Let's go. Come on, we can bring him down. Okay, maybe we can't. Let's break out. Let's go. Come on. Let's go.
Around the corner, I found a muster of cyborgs. I quickly began running in circles because if they ganged up on me all at once, I would definitely die. I lured them into an oil pit near my base and I trapped them and I slowly took them out while they were stuck. This was the Pog play. The next morning, I began gathering some concrete for my next build. I wanted to build a futuristic farm for my villagers to harvest crops more efficiently. I headed out of my base to gather some sand, but I was wary as the outside world was growing more dangerous and more aliens and cyborgs were beginning to circle my base. All of a sudden, robots began chasing me, but I made it away from them, and on my way out to find some sand, I found some chests in an old building and I looted them. I found these weird first aid items, so I tried them on myself to see what they did. I couldn't figure it out, so I just let them be for now. I later found a small river with some sand in it and I began gathering up all the sand I would need for my new farm.
Oh, it's another one of those NPCs. Okay, I turned him into a farmer. I just want more farmers because the culture is going to thrive off of farming at the beginning. And then from there, we can just... we'll just decimate everything. But we need to get farming up and running first.
I began clearing out the area to make the giant farm. I then began the creation of the farm. While building, I began to think the power suit armor was not going to be enough to face the mothership. I need to take the next step now. Becoming an android with a human brain, this would allow me to have the genetic modifications while still maintaining control over myself. To do this, I'd need to locate the tower of the mad scientist and have him sell me the genetic code to change myself. However, nobody had visited that tower in a very long time, and by now it was probably overrun by cyborgs and other different types of entities, and to get there, I would need to fight through them all. When the farm was complete, I headed inside and I placed some water sources and covered them with some fir wood. I then made some new tools and destroyed my old farm so my villagers would begin farming the new land. I grabbed some of the gray concrete and made a path from the central road to the front of my new farm. I planted some seeds inside the farm and then headed back out to get the resources my robot had mined up. I broke the turtle and then went back to my base and crafted another turtle. Expanding my resources gathering was a must. I gathered the required resources to make the second mining robot. I placed down the turtles and ran their commands when all of a sudden another drone attacked me. A giant robot then started moving towards me, but I juked him and ran back into my base and escaped his grip. When I was inside my base, I tried to sleep, but it wouldn't let me. I waited out the night and the next morning I grabbed the resources from my farms and made some food. It was now time to venture out and find the scientist to become a cyborg.
Alright, so I have my android torso and my android leg. I think the scientist is going to need a few more parts, but I have to go see what he wants. But first I have to find him. Okay, I can grab all these resources. I made my new pickaxe. Now I just need to go out and find his lair. I don't think it's too far from my base. I've seen it on the minimap before, but it might take a little while to get there. Alright, let's go.
I began making my way towards a large structure I'd seen on the minimap earlier. As I got farther away though, I realized that I had never gone this far from my base and I didn't know what to expect.
Alright, now this looks like what we're looking for. I just need to find the door. Now I'm not sure if there's gonna be like defenses or anything.
Alright, now this looks like what we're looking for. I just need to find the door. Now, I'm not sure if there'll be any defenses or anything, or even if he has a door for that matter. Oh, turrets. I think they're empty though. I think we're good. Okay, let's head in. Oh! Okay, that's... what kind of door is that? It goes nowhere. An architect probably built that one.
Where is it supposed to go? It just cut off the side of a building. Okay.
Oh, these are elevator blocks. All right, let's go up. Oh, no, 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 no. Let's go down. Let's go down.
All right. Okay, let's try that again. Up and back, back, back. There we go. Okay.
I began beating away the half zombie, half cyborg and making my way up floor by floor.
Okay, let's go up. There's nobody up here. How far do I have to go? All right, how many more floors are in here? Oh. Oh, okay, this is him. What the heck is that? I don't want to know. Okay, this is the dude that you need to find. Okay. Hey there, buddy. Burp. I guess my name is Burp. I want to become an android. All right. Oh, this is ominous. Finally, getting rid of that fragile body is the best choice. The only problem is that I need you to bring me a set of android parts. Alright, well, if we want to become an android, then we have to go collect some more parts. Which means we have to go out at nighttime and kill some of these androids. That's gonna be fun. Alright, I'm not sure how powerful these androids are that we're looking for, but I don't think these are the androids. I think these are, like, failed androids. I think the androids are gonna be much more... that looks more like an android. Okay. So keep my distance. Come on. Stay away, stay back. That definitely looks like an android. Okay, he does damage. He does a fair amount of damage. And there he goes. So he didn't drop anything. So I guess it's only a chance that they'll drop something. Oh, it's a boy. Man's taller than me. Stay back, stay back. Nope, nope. Oh, I'm juking. I'm so good. I need powerful armor. Like, this is... here we go. Oh, a legendary android head. I don't know what that is, but I think that's something useful. Okay, So, what do we have? We have a torso, a leg. So we need an arm, is what I'm guessing. And I bet you there's some of these bad boys in here. I hate going into these buildings. You never know what's gonna be around. We got a chest. Ooh, that's some good stuff. Definitely take the emeralds as well. Help build our city a little bit. And we'll take the bones. All right, this is the last room I think on. Oh, okay, we got some cyber. Oh, there's a lot of them. There's a lot. Oh, there's another one. Okay, keep him at the door. Oh, hello, okay, sorry. All right, die, perish. Please, oh, thank you. Oh, someone attack me? I think that's it. Okay, so we still just have the leg, the helmet. We still need an arm. All right, well, I have to keep pushing then to beat another building.
I pushed into another building and found a group of androids at the top. I took them out, and then they dropped me the arm that I needed. It was a really dangerous battle, but thankfully I survived.
All right, I'm really hoping that's all the android parts that we need, but it must be, right? We have all the body parts, and then all he has to do is somehow put them on us. Is that just me, or is he outside? What the heck? Why is he out there? How am I supposed to, like, get out there and, Oh, that's why he's out there! That's why he's out there! What is this? This is in a cage! No, 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 no! What are you? Come on, take him down, come on! Yes, go! Okay, let's go find the scientist. Alright, this is just slightly dangerous, no biggie. Just don't fall to your death and then we'll be fine, right? Oh, okay, let's just make a little bridge here. Where did he go? He was somewhere on this edge. Okay, I think he was on the bottom ledge. So let's fall down here. He's somewhere around here. Let's break in. All right, there he is. Perfect. All right, I want to become an android. I have all the parts. Boys, there's no going back after this. Like, once you become an android, you can't... Well, you can go back, but it requires you to die, and we can't do that, so... I have all the parts. Ooh, what's happening? What's happening? Okay. Constructing neural pathways. Neural configure. Boys, we're becoming a cyborg. My health is gone. Oh, it's in the top left. Oh, and I have a battery meter? Oh. Oh, what was that? I don't know what I just did, but I was like fast for a second. Okay, so now we can, like, upgrade my components and become so strong. Alright. Well, thank you, scientist. Now we just gotta get back to base. We gotta get back to base now. Okay, let's go. I think the first thing that I want to do as an android is get rid of the food bar. Because I don't want to have to eat food. And then I think it regenerates you with power instead. Yeah, I think that's what I want to do first.
This was the last part I needed. It was now time. I could not delay the inevitable anymore. Now that I was an android, the only thing stopping me from pushing into the heart of the alien invasion was to level up my abilities and get stronger armor. I made my way back into my base and began mining out the basement. I wanted to begin working on some sort of better tech, but I needed more open space, so I started clearing out the entire area in the basement and filling in the gaps in the floor. I went to gather some wood when I noticed a robot outside of the fence, and all of a sudden it let out a crazy yelp and was attacked by an alien parasite. No, 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 no. Two giant robots then made it to the wall and one just decided to climb right over. After healing, I engaged him. He had a crazy amount of health, but he was crazy slow as well, so I used distance and my tech sword to slowly bring him down. I then made a bunch of chests. I wanted to sort my resources and bring everything to the basement. I then began transferring the resources into my basement.
There is nothing more satisfying than breaking these chests and then just collecting everything up at the same time. It's just so much fun. I do this, like, purposefully every time, just so that I can do that. Alright, let's go check out how many ores. Oh my goodness, I hate that. Hopefully we can get rid of that with some upgrades. Holy cats, have they mined out a lot. There's gotta be a lot of resources in here. Okay, I think the first machine here I want to make is the redstone furnace. This way I don't need to use coal, and I can just use the generator to power it. And then we can start working on a better source for power. All right, here we go. So if we move this, and then if we place this right here, then it should gain power as soon as this is filled, right? It can't power both because the generator is too small. So let's start working on power then. So to make the next source of power, I want to make a nuclear reactor.
Now, can this... Okay, so Eulorium works like Uranium, and that will enable me to actually build the reactor and then power it. Okay, and then once we've unlocked that... All right, let's go back upstairs. Something doesn't seem right up here. Okay, they're fitting each other. I can kind of hear something. I just want to go investigate and see what it is. Let's not get hit by these guys. It sounds like a flapping noise. It almost sounds like the Ender Dragon, but there's no way the Ender Dragon could be here. What is... what is that? What? No. Okay, no. We're not investigating what that is. Wow, hopefully the thing doesn't come towards my base. I have no idea what that was. No. Okay, let's get back inside. Okay, so this is the next machine that we need to make, and this will, like, recharge ourself, basically. Tritanium. I think I have... Yeah, I thought it was this ore. Okay. Once this finishes, we can start crushing down this. Because to charge ourselves and to heal ourselves, we're gonna need one of these. So we get the resources.
I went upstairs to smelt some coal into graphite. This was a key component in making my reactor. All of a sudden, I noticed a random villager visiting my town hall, so I ran and grabbed my money token and converted him into a miner. I then realized I had enough emeralds to make a new structure, so I grabbed some cobblestone and gravel and made an awful-looking mineshaft. I placed the mining marker on top of it and then went away to see if the miner would start mining there. I returned to my lab and continued crafting components and made the charging station. Now I wouldn't die. This was going fairly well. I grabbed my graphite and began making blocks required to make the nuclear reactor. The reactor runs on Eulorium and outputs a crazy amount of power. I mined the floor next to the charging station and began placing the blocks.
Alright, so a reactor is pretty simple to set up in its very base form. We're not going to be building a very big one. So I'm just going to build this base with reactor casing. And then this is what actually holds... This is what actually holds the uranium. So I put this control rod on top. And then all I need to do is surround this with reactor casing. We might need a bit more of it. At the front, we put the controller, I think. And then at the side... Well, actually, let's put the power tap. This is where all the power is going to be generated from. And then we're going to put... This is where we put in the actual uranium. Let's put it on this side. Okay. Let's make a bit more reactor casing. All right, I think 8 should be enough. So if we place it here... That's just... that's a little bit tricky. Okay, let's put it right there. Perfect. Oh, we might be like one short. Okay, we're too short. All right, I think we're good if we place these last two. Boom. Okay, so now this is a nuclear reactor. All right, let's try not blowing this up in my base. That'd be great. Okay, let's get our uranium. Let's put the uranium inside. And there we go. Okay, we have power. So now we just need to hook this up to the charger. All right, so we made some power cables. I don't know if there's like a specific spot. Oh, I think probably right here. Okay, let's put that there. Let's bring this up. Oh, we need to start the reactor. Okay, and then let's start the reactor. And then if we walk close to it, there we go. Look, on the top left, we're charging back. So this is actually charging us. This is so cool. Okay. Okay, now we can kind of take a breath. We know we're going to survive. Now it's time to upgrade ourselves and begin tinkering. Whoa, what is going on here? That person looks very sad. Holy biscuits, what did they just do? He just built this giant tunnel. They just mine in a straight line from wherever you put this. Oh, that didn't work very well. Okay, let's just, let's not have that there. Okay, we're just gonna plug up this entrance that they just made. All right, we're gonna have to work something out for that, but, we need to go find some more parts first.
I went back into my base and began making the parts to finish my armor set. I then made a power fist. This tool was incredibly OP. It can shoot plasma cannons, it can mine blocks. I just need to get the parts to upgrade it now. I spent some time hovering over the possible upgrades. I then made some parts and I added them to the railgun and I tested it. Oh, this thing is crazy. My leggings power it by the kinetic motor inside of them, so I'm always gonna have energy as long as I keep moving. I tried the new gun on a robot outside and I absolutely melted it. Once I was able to upgrade this thing even more, I could make my way to the mother
ship. I then made the power suit helmets and boots. I was ready for the next task. I made a solar panel to upgrade my helmet to accept light sources as a way of power, but I needed another circuit that I didn't have, and it was now time to go and find those circuits. There was an underground abandoned civilization I had to find, and inside I could find a bunch of electrical parts. I would have to find the caverns, and then find the final room where the treasure was held to unlock my true potential as a cyborg.
So I upped the voltage on this hand. I just want to see how much. Oh, it does so much damage. Let's go. I think it's using the energy from my leggings to do this. Eventually, it can be a pickaxe, too. Oh, that. Holy. This thing is so OP. Okay, it doesn't look like anything's down there. Let's make our way. We just need to find some more parts. Oh, okay. Hello. All right, let's see what's in these chests. Oh, not. I can eat that, I think. What was that noise? I think we're good. An ion thruster, that's gonna be useful for... That's gonna be useful too. That one's empty. All right, let's grab the bones just for fun. All right, there's so many options to go. Okay, let's keep, ooh, some free experience. Don't mind if I do. I haven't seen that before. He's got a purple mask on. What was that noise? Oh! Oh, hello! Why are you pointing that at me? Okay, we're good. Cool? Cool, bro? Alright, epic. Alright, it's hard to tell, like, which pathway to go down. But I think we're going down the right one. I just want to make sure the hallway's clear. What does that do? Ooh! These guys are sick! Oh, something has me pinned down! Something has me pinned down! What the heck is that? Oh, what are you? Not chapel, not chapel, not chapel. This is not good. This is not good. I need to heal. I need to heal. He's gonna keep pushing me. Oh! I got him. What was that? Okay, we need to sit back and heal here for a minute. Holy. Okay, that looks new. I haven't seen any structures. Oh, that's a very loud water sound like that before. Does this lead somewhere, or... I am tempted to jump in. But I'll try it. Ow! No, it doesn't lead anywhere. Just... Alright, bye. Alright, this looks new. That way, or that way? Oh! Oh, hello, everybody!
I continued blasting the aliens with my new weapon into the oblivion.
No, 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 no. Hello, hello, friends. I don't want to make friends with any of you. You're all really ugly. And you have weird eyes.
I found the final room after killing all but one alien and I challenged him. I backed up and took him down.
Oh, spoiled little ones. I need to heal. Jack the cyborg, why do you exist? No, no, please. Okay, looks like I'm too far and he can't see me. Let's go. How dare you, I would tell you to pieces. Well, you're dead, so. Everybody's coming, it's a party. Phase two. Okay, this is ridiculous. I keep getting knocked back so much. I had to kill him. Stay back. Stay back. Oh, you're a fast boy. Oh. What did he drop? Holy. Okay. Hold up. Hold up. That is some pog loot. Cyber crystals. Okay, that's actually... Yeah, we should have thrown everything in here. Okay, what is in this? Oh. Yes, that's exactly what we needed. Okay, let's actually take a look at this. So, as a cyborg, I can upgrade my stuff. Oh, automatically activates a shield ability when attacked at range. So, from what I understand, I can either do attack, or I can do... I'm gonna do defense. I think defense is better. So, if I buy that... So, that takes away my XP. Holy, that took 15! Okay, let's get nano armor. Oh, it needs to be 4? There's no way I'm gonna be able to afford that. Let's just look through here. Night vision. Actually, I'll take night vision. Limb overclocking. I'll take that once. Step assist, don't care. Oh, all of my XP is gone. Okay, but let's, oh, this could take a minute. All right, grab that, and then let's check what's in here.
So they put a bunch of different robot parts in here. I will take it. Also, I want that chest. And the gold is another chest in here. Okay, there's nothing in it. All right, let's get out of this horrible place and head home.
I began my journey home, thinking about the next task, as it was heavy on my mind. When I got home, I began applying all the upgrades to my modular power suit. I added the batteries to all the pieces of armor and added energy generation to every piece as well. However, my mind was heavy in thought. The next task was clear. I had to find a way to get to the mothership and face the ruler who took over Earth. This was not easy. The mothership was miles in the sky and held an evil so powerful I may not be a match for it. I grabbed some android parts and I added them onto my new armor skin in the android enhancement table. Inside of the dungeon, I found a satellite. The only way I could reach the mothership is if I bring it near to Earth, and placing the satellite was the only way to do that. It would ping a signal back to the mothership and let them know where I am, the last of humanity. This was risky, but I needed to do it if I wanted a chance at defeating them. If I defeated the invasion, the mothership would be within reach, but if I failed, humanity would be wiped off the Earth. This was a huge risk. I noticed the wandering trader in the village and grabbed some wheat to trade with him. I noticed he traded diamonds as well, so I ran in and grabbed some, but he only traded the diamonds at the villager's mine. I traded my wheat. The emeralds were going to be essential to the defense of the base. I then added a module onto my fist to allow me to mine blocks, but time was ticking and I needed to get my defense up now. I ran over to my robot's mines and began collecting all the resources from the chests. I'd need every last iron ingot if I was going to stand up to the army that was coming. This was the last stand. I spent a while running back and forth gathering the resources from the chests back to my home base.
All right, to make the next machine, we're gonna need some grains of infinity, and to get those, we're gonna need to dive all the way down there. All right, let's go. Is that alien still here? It is. Oh, I was hoping I could hit it. Okay, I need to, oh, perfect, he's almost dead, okay. If I light this on fire, then it should, I think, drop grains of infinity when the fire burns out. Let's see. Perfect, there's one right over there. It's gonna be needed to make our next machine. We're gonna need quite a few of them. Collect all the ones we have here, and then, oh, how are we gonna get back up? It looks like some of the blocks from the chests dropped down here, so that worked out perfectly. We can use them to climb all the way back up. As a robot, I don't do well in water, so I'm trying to avoid that.
I then began crafting the next machine, the alloy smelter. I needed it for the gun turrets I would need to make to defend the base. I placed it next to my power supply, and then it powered up. I needed electrified steel, so I began gathering the resources to make it. Silicone, pulverized coal, and iron. This was an essential crafting component to making the gun turrets, and they were essential to defending my base. The hordes that were coming were no easy task. Gathering the many resources needed for the turrets was time-consuming, and the clock was ticking. The final day was nearing. I added another android component to my head. This would give me more defense, and all of a sudden, the game informed me that we had reached difficulty level 15. This was going to be crazy. It was now time to raise walls around the base. I upped the speed of my mining hand and tore down the old blocks surrounding my camp.
Alright, so I think after we get rid of this wall here, the first thing I want to do is I want to build a too high wall of obsidian. And then we're going to reinforce it with some spikes, and then put the turrets behind that. Got to keep these guys at bay for as long as we can. If we survive the full night, then we have a chance of making it to the mothership.
And I began placing obsidian around the base. I knew this wall wouldn't hold the hordes, but it was time to slow them down and allow my turrets to mow them down a little bit. I raised the walls too high and then put a slab on top to stop the mobs from spawning. I added some spikes to the outside of the walls to stop them from charging in. I did this to both sides of the base.
Alrighty, today's the day. Okay, I want to place all of the turrets on some sort of pillar. I think this one works the best. So here's the thing, they can attack from two directions. So I think the best way is to put two on each direction and then one guarding my home base. So if we put the turret base down like this and the turret on top, then all we need to do is load it and attach to some power. So let's put one over here as well on the other side of the camp. All right, let's put one on this far wall. Probably like right here. Is this gonna be, it's not a great line of sight. Let's put it over here where I can see more of what's going on. I might just have one over here as sort of like a central tower. And then I think it comes down to like protecting this region right here. So let's put one behind this wall, make it a little bit harder to get at for them. Okay, and then let's place one on top of here. I think this would also be a pretty good place to put that.
Okay, perfect. Now we just need to hook them. Oh, we're stuck. We just need to hook them all up to power now. So that's what these guys are for. I don't want to run the power along the ground because they can break the wires if I do that. So we have to run the power across the top. All right, so I think they're all connected. Actually, no, one more still needs to be connected. Can I get out, please? Thank you. Okay, now everything is connected. So what I think I want to do is I want to bring it around here. Because they have to get through this wall. I feel like if they get to here, then we're in trouble. Let's bring the cable down to here. And then let's bring it into the main warehouse. Oh, we need more cable. Okay, well, good thing we had some left over from before because I literally could not make any more right now. Perfect. Oh, now it's perfect. Okay, so let's go see if the turrets are armed now. All right, they're armed. And then the range is at max. So now we just need to get a bunch of ammo for them. What I think I want to do is I want to put a lot of ammo in the more central turrets. And then in the outside turrets, I won't put as much because I didn't really have enough. Oh, I need to connect that one still. Okay, I didn't have enough really to max out every turret. So if we put two stacks in each and then we heavy load these middle ones. How much did I put in here? Let's take two stacks out. Let's put a stack in there. And then we'll put a stack on the far one just because they're probably going to breach the walls and I may as well be ready for that. Okay, boys, we are running out of time. We need to do this now. Okay, so the last step I think is to convert all of my settlers into warriors and have them fight with me because that's really our only chance of defending this place. So if I go to you, you trade me that. I don't want that. I want you, I think. Yes. So you will convert blacksmith, enchanter, bard, guards. So if I give you emeralds, you're going to give me the guard tokens. I have no choice. I know it sucks. You have to waste the emeralds. But we got to turn all these guys into guards. Guard. Guard. And making another guard. Oh, hello. Let's make you a guard as well. All right. We got everybody that we can have, basically. All right. I want to add one more attachment. I want to add the plasma cannon. Let's turn everything up. And then let's salvage the railgun. And then, what does this do? Actually, I don't want to blow up my base. All right, let's try this outside. Ooh, that looks cool. I wonder how much damage that does. We'll have to find, I'm sure we'll have enough mobs here soon. Let's move this turret over though. Holy, that's huge. Okay, get everyone in position and we need to hold this. Hold this at all costs.
It was time. Night fell and the hordes began to charge.
We need to get up there and see if we can help them out a little bit. How many? Oh, what's attacking me? What is attacking me? There's drones inside. Stay back. Hey, I don't know if I like this plasma cannon. I guess it does like an area damage, which is good.
I jumped on the wall and began using my arm to repel them using plasma blasts. The fighting began fierce as my turrets fired, but I was holding the line. Little did I know that on the other side of the compound, a new danger was lurking.
Okay, we just gotta keep holding them. The turret is still going. Okay, I don't wanna be near them because if they hit me, it's gonna be a lot of damage. Okay, let's keep them back. I think we're doing good. We might be able to hold this off. Let's keep going. All right, we're still holding them. I think we can, oh, they're inside. They're inside the base. How did they get in? How did they get in? No, 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 no. We need to change this out. We need to, no, they're in the backside too. No, this is not good. This is not good. What health are we at? Okay, there's a big hole. There's a big old hole. Oh, it's enough. Oh, they're jumping over. Okay, stay back. We need to retreat. We need to retreat. We need to get inside the, well, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. We need to get in. We need to get inside the base. Keep them outside. Keep them outside the walls. All the turrets are firing on them. This is the best position we can have for them. Come on. Come on. Come on. Don't fail me now, plasma cannon. I need this. Oh, shoot. They're literally everywhere. Oh, I let one in. I let one in. How did I do that? No, stay back. Stay back. He's so strong. He's so strong. All right, we took them out. We broke a pressure plate. Okay, turrets are taking them out. We just gotta survive till morning. I'm stupid ship. All right, let's go, boys. Let's go, come on. We can keep them at bay. We can keep them. Okay, my soldiers are starting to help, I think. Oh, that man, okay. I think I might've just shot him.
This is not good. We have no thing. No. Oh shoot. I need to get up. Ah! No, get in. No, they're inside. We need to get down now. Hey, I knew I had jet boots, but I have no idea how to use them. I don't know.
Oh!
Am I flying? Let's get outside. Oh, how do I go down?
Let's go! We can fly!
Oh, I'm coming for that stupid mothership. Okay, we just need to get rid of these mobs around our base first. We just save as many villagers as we can, because this is ridiculous. I think Daybreak's coming, too.
Daybreak is here! Let's go!
If we can just stay literally up here, the rain's clearing up. Let's go! Okay, everything has frozen. I'm so confused. Did I win? I don't know. Everything's frozen. I'm so confused.
Alright, we gotta push it. We have to push it now. No! No! Where's it going? No! It's gone. Are you kidding me right now? That was our... The only way we're gonna get to that spaceship is literally if we go to space now.
Mobs are dead, eh? Can we get to space? Do we have enough resources? Oh, okay. This is... Okay, guys. Everybody calm down, alright? Calm down.
I was walking around the village looking at the damage when all of a sudden...
What is happening? I think my game just crashed.
Oh! Oh, it did not crash! It did not crash! I just got teleported! What the heck?
No. You, please stay back. Okay, this gun thing is not working well. Okay, we can take him. Oh, he jumps! This man's got a hurt. No. Okay, I think we can shoot our cannon like every once in a while, but it's not very consistent. Okay, I can't shoot. It's not letting me. I have to run at him. Okay, let's go. Let's not get punched off the edge here. Or we just have to stay. Oh, he's doing an attack. He's doing one of those crazy attacks. Okay, we just have to keep him at a distance. Oh, it's just this stupid thing doesn't work all the time. Oh, he's frozen. Game's frozen. Something's frozen. I can get him. No, I can't get him. Oh, there I go. Okay, let's get him back. I almost got shot off the edge. Oh, okay, he's doing explosions. Why am I out of sprint? Oh, my battery's running low. Okay, I need to get him off. I'm not gonna be able to finish him. Come on. Oh, I'm so slow. Come on. Okay, I don't know what that noise was. Come on. Okay, I'm out. It's not letting me shoot. My battery's running. Okay, my battery's not good. Come on. Get it to the edge. Where's he going? Where'd he go? Ooh, he's flying again. Why are you flying? Come on. You take like no knockback. This is ridiculous. Get off. There he goes. Okay, so how do we get back to the overworld?
Make sure to check out the vlog channel. The link will be in the description. And also, we're trying to hit 80 million subscribers by the end of 2020. So hit that subscribe button.